Good morning to you all. Today we deal about the engineering graphics. In engineering graphics, what are the different projections we will see, and later in different coordinates, different location of a points, and joining of a points, and joining of a lines, we develop a frame, and frame we develop a solid. From solid we draw the sectional planes and developments. Later we will see the isometric and orthographic. In that starting, so we will discuss about engineering graphics. So in engineering graphics, what I said first, you will see point. So in point, you will mark a point here. So from point, you name as a P1. From P1 to next another P1, we name as P2. So joining of two points, we will get line. So next topic is line. Okay, from now you join four lines. So joining of lines, we will get an surface. So next topic is, so we will mark here as a b c d. So from joining of four lines, we will got surface. Okay, so now joining of surfaces, we will develop a solid. So joining of, so here starting point, so joining of two points, we get a line. So from line we will get a surface, from surface we get a solid. So solid means, see, this is one surface. As I mentioned, joining of a surface, we will get solids. So now we will take another surface. Okay, so then another surface, so we will got solid. So here two points, joining of a lines, we get surface. From joining of a surface, we get solids. So from this solid is the last topic of our subject. So from here we discuss isometric view, orthographic view, top view, side view, front view, and all. So before that, we will talk about points. So points, before we are starting about a point, we have to mention where it is. So for that, we have developed one system format, that is coordinate systems. So we will discuss that one. Okay, so we will see here, we will take an coordinate systems. So in this coordinate, here this is first quadrant. So this is first quadrant, this is second quadrant, and this is third quadrant, and this is fourth quadrant. So here we will say that where is the point is located. So this is the first unit of our subject. So if the point was here, let me name as A. So for to translate our location of a point, we will say this is vertical plane. So we will represent as VP. And this plane entirely, we will say vertical plane. This plane we will say as horizontal plane, denote as HP. So planes means, we will see like this. Okay. So if now this A is a point which is above HP. Like this we will denote. Above HP. This is above HP, in front of VP. So here we will say this is like this position, this is like this position. So in front of VP. Okay, so we denote that A. Next, coming to here, second coordinate, if the point is here, it is denoted by a B. We will say it is behind VP, and this is above HP. So now coming to third quadrant, if the point is here and denoted as C, we will say it is below HP, and so this is a vertical plane. We will say that it is in this direction, so behind VP. So below HP, behind VP. If the point is D, which is in fourth quadrant, then we will say it is below HP and in front of VP. So in this way we will say that location of a point. So after that, before to mention the location of a point, it has to be drawn in 2D dimensions. So we will take one reference line entire for 4. So this is one plane, this is other plane, this is other plane, and this is other plane. So we will take considered only quadrant 1. We will take like this. If the point was here, so this is the actual plane. So we will rotate this one in 90 degrees. So we can able to draw this A. This is front view. Front view, and from this direction we will say top view. Top view. So this shadow will observe here. So here this is called front view. So one important point we have to say that for front view, A dash we will represent it. It is in A dash. So for top view, we will represent in A. We will take only small letters. We will not use anywhere, but only in question we will take capital letters. In answers we will take only small letters. So this is top view, front view. We will denote by A dash. This is front view, A dash, top view, A, and side view also. Sometimes we will take, that is A double dash. Most of times we will not use this one, only we will use front view and top view. So see, from here it is above here, so here we represent as A dash. From this direction, so now it is top view, it is represented here, so we will say A. So in question it will give a point A is 20 mm above HP and 10 mm in front of VP. So we will draw this one here taking an XY line. XY line. Okay. You will take one XY line and we will draw, now we will draw this in here. So if question is 20 mm, if the question is 20 mm above HP and another 10 mm in front of VP, we will now locate this point in this. So after rotating this one in 90 degrees, so we will get this is VP and this is HP. So anything if we say it is above HP, we will come, it is as XY line, this is XY line. So it is mentioned above. So here you got a 20 mm above HP. So it is denoted taking here and we mark here. This is one point, this is noted as A dash. Why not A dash? This is front view. So we are seeing from this one, it is represented above XY line. So we will mark one line like this. Point, this is slow, in lightly we have to mark. Only this point should be visible more. So this dimension is like this, we have to represent as. So this is 20 mm above HP and top view. We can observe from here only, the distance will be like this. By rotating 90 degrees, we will come here. So how much? 10 distance. From here we will take 10. So this should be 10 mm. So we will draw here one point. This is A. So anyone can understand. If we keep A dash, this is front view. So no need, you should not write in answer. They can easily understand that A dash, it shows the front view. So A, it shows the top view. So in this format, we will do different exercises. So if the question given behind the VP and above HP, then it is considered as second coordinate. And in some questions, we will get below HP, behind VP. So this is third quadrant. And another one, below HP, in front of VP. So like this, we will discuss in different locations. This is about points. So now, if you know exactly about the point, next we will deal about the lines. Okay. In this only we can see how line is mentioned. See, in question we get a line AB. Okay, first we have to know the questions only, then only we can able to write the answers. Okay, na? So if the question says that a line AB, it is 10 mm above HP and like that. So this is a line which is 30 mm long. So in engineering graphics, all the dimensions are in mm only. So no need to separately mention 30 mm, 40 mm like that. It is always in mm only. So if the line is here, so in question you said a line 30 mm AB, A is 30 mm above HP, means line is here. Okay. So this height A, which is 30 mm above HP, and another B, it is somewhere, we can't exactly say, but in question you can see the point B is inclined. Two conditions is there. One is it will give height. It will give height. Like how means A, B is 30 mm or 40 mm above HP, like that you will give. Otherwise, the line is inclined. Inclined to 30 degrees to VP or like that. So in coming to lines, we have different concepts. Coming to line, that is line, lines. In lines, we will see conditions. First one, line parallel to both the planes. Parallel to both the planes. Parallel to both the planes. And next one, parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP. And next condition, reverse. Parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. Next one, incline. Incline to VP and parallel to HP. And other conditions, incline to HP and parallel to VP. And last conditions, incline to both the planes. Inclined to both the planes. These are the different conditions we will see in projections of a lines. And same format we will see like this only in for surfaces also. For surfaces also we will see same format. In that, if you see surfaces, surface or plane, planes. See, if you take and polygons. Polygons means more than four sides which is equally lengthed. All sides are equal. So in that polygons we will see a pentagon. So pentagon means five sides. Okay. Five sides. So we will take like this. If the pentagon is like that, we will say this all sides are equal. So here this is called edge. We will call this is as edge. Okay, this is surface. So this one, everything is surface, and this one is corner. So in question we will get the surface is inclined to HP or the surface is inclined to VP, or other conditions, the edge is on HP or the edge is on VP, or the edge is inclined to HP, inclined to VP. Like that we will cover in surfaces. So based upon the question we will see. So here also, from now I said already, so this is about planes. So from planes, if we come to solids, this is the last and most important and easy also. So coming to solids, okay. So solids, here we already discussed isometric view and orthographic view. So isometric and orthographic is nothing but 2D and 3D. As we all know that 2D and 3D generally we are talking. But coming to 2D means two dimension. That is 2 in X and Y direction. So it is called two dimension. Coming to 3D, we will say X, Y and Z. This is 3D dimension. So the development of a object in all dimensions, so we will call as 3D. So now see, we will represent an object in X and Y direction. as we all already studied in 10th and intermediate. So what we will do? We will take this is as a x and this is as a y. If anyone asks to draw a polygon, you will write like this. So see, this is in x direction, in y direction. So we will represent as a values. This is a 30 mm or 20 mm side. So we will develop this. But coming to 3D, so that is called isometric to orthographic. Isometric to orthographic. So what we are done, system is there. In that system only we can able to draw an object. For that we will take one XY line. Okay. So one line. So we will take one reference lines. This is called reference lines. So this should be in light, only visible to the drawer. So it should be not appearance to all. So we will take this one. From this we will develop an object. See, if any question we got, develop an hexagon. Okay. Hexagon and everything. Or otherwise any object we should be drawn in 3D, we will take like this. This is the reference. So from here we will take, this is on 30 degrees line in this direction and 30 degrees line in this direction. Okay, this is the basics. So from this only we can able to draw any object. If the question gives, develop a hexagon, prism or pyramid, that is a new topic, so we have to discuss in later. So see, if anyone asks to draw you a solid object, hexagonal, so we will take like this. See, first we have to draw like this a line. Okay. From this line, parallel to this, we will draw another line. Okay. So which is given in dimension. So we will take this one as side 40. Okay. So this one we will take side, this one. Next, parallel to this one, we will draw like this. So this is the one surface base. And next, coming to this, we will develop a line like this. So for visible purpose, I am drawing a side. So not coincidence with the reference line. So see, parallel to this line. Next, parallel to this line. So see, parallel to this line. So parallel to this line. So this is a basic solid object. Now parallel to already drawn line, and next parallel to this side, parallel to this. So we will develop a solid object. So this is basics. So from this we can able to develop an object. If he is to ask any isometry of hexagon, we will draw here an hexagon. We will take like this. So we will draw here hexagon. From this hexagon we develop like this, and again we will draw another plane. Okay. Okay, this is the method to draw isometric to orthographic. In solids, we will take, we have two types of solids. One is prisms, and another one is pyramid. Okay, so these are the two topics in solids. So coming to prism, so prism, you already know, prism is like this, which will keep boards and anyway, it looks like a jail. So that's why you call prism. And I'm coming to pyramids, it is in pyramid shape. As you all know that pyramids and all, so we will see like this. So coming to here, any base, it may be pentagon prism or hexagon prism or octagon prism, any inside of prism. So the front view will be visible in like this only. So it is in rectangle. But coming to pyramid, it is visible in triangular shape. So I will show the prism here. So prism is, see, if you develop on pentagon prism, okay, so like this. So this is base parallel to this one, this and this. See, this is on pentagonal prism. So coming to same pentagon pyramid, so coming that we will see this is one pentagon prism. So here only one point is there. So from that point we will draw like this. Okay, see, this is like a pyramid shape. So difference is both will have axis, but here we will represent A, B, C, D, E. And for this also A, B, C, D, E. Coming to this point, we will denote this point as apex. Apex. This we have to remember. So it is denoted by letter O. From here, but we will take here, this is no apex is there. Same different sides are there. That's why we will take this one as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So for easy identification of this two surfaces, we will take one is alphabet surface and another one is numerical surface. So these are the different solids. We will take here square, if you consider as hexagon. Hexagon, here also we can develop hexagon pyramid also. Like that we can take any number of components. Mostly we will use only pentagon and hexagon. So we can easily cover up this topic. So okay, these are the different topics in engineering graphics. Thank you to one and all.